there, guys, what's going on? My name's Mark, and welcome back to another episode of our FIFA 19 PW United Road to Glory career mode. Now, in between the episodes, I've played a few games. I've played, 6 games, but I've got highlights of 3 of them for you, because the other ones were quite shit. So here are those highlights. So kicking off these highlights, we hosted Leicester at the A-backs, and just 2 minutes into the game, Max Evans tries the cross. Luckily for him, it falls to Gomez, shoots, but that's just hit the post. Memphis now holding the ball up, playing a lovely ball over the top to Gomez, on the volley, off the bar. Gomez hits the woodwork for the second time in the match. Leicester now coming forward, ball played back to Ricardo, first time in, Cortez clears, only as far as him. Bagayoko hits one, and it's a lovely finish from the former Chelsea man. Let's have a look at this from behind. The spin on it and the power on it, it was just too powerful for Oblak to get there in time, and Leicester take the lead. Memphis now with a free kick in a dangerous position, over the wall, and for the third time in this match, we hit that fucking woodwork. That's how that one finished, 1-0 to Leicester. We were the better side, but Leicester just took their one chance. That was literally their only chance of the game, and they fucking scored with it. I only put this game in because it's our first loss of the season, so it's a disappointing one, isn't it? But we can't keep our heads down for long, as after the Leicester game, we took on Manchester City at the Abax Stadium. Max Evans now sprinting away down the wing. He does this so often. Cuts inside his man. Looks for a ball. He's got one in Memphis Depay. Bit of a scruffy finish, but we'll take it all day long. We will accept that. Thank you very much. A bit of a scruffy one the way it just squeezes underneath Edison, but our number 9 will take it all bloody day. Memphis now playing a ball up to Angel Gomez. Gomez gets past his man. Spins Alexandro here. Hits it with the outside of his foot. Good save by Edison. Falls to Memphis, but unfortunately for us, it was on his weaker foot. Riyad Mahrez now just about keeping this ball in there, drills it towards the front post for De Bruyne, but he glances his header wide. I've tried to commentate on this far too many times, but I can't get it right. Eventually falls to Mahrez though, but luckily for us, the shot was right at Oblak. Let's have a game of keepy up, shall we? Alexandro ball, then Mason Price heads it up rather than out. Lewis Reed, Kevin De Bruyne. Kevin De Bruyne gets the better, back and forth. De Bruyne again heads it, falls to Foden, back to De Bruyne. Shot though, but that's a vital deflection by Cortez to put it wide. Bit of a jammy cross coming up here. Danilo hits the chest of Benucci into De Bruyne, but the header's right at Oblak, and he gives him a little fake throw there just to piss him off. Second half starts the exact way the first half was going. Man City dominating us. Jesus into Sane. Sane finds Foden. Foden hits it on the turn. It hits Mahrez. Goes in. But luckily for us, the Algerian was offside, and that assistant referee has got his flag up. Maybe we can come forward now and get a little rare attack for once. Gomez now waiting for the run. He's got it now. Cedric Hendricks. Look at Max Evans peeling away at the back post. Hendricks finds him. Max Evans! How in the holy shit has he put that wide? But that is how that one finished. A 1-0 victory. We have snatched those points. We do not deserve a win from that game. You saw the highlight. We were dominated, but that bald fraud couldn't get the better of us, could he? I'm pretty sure it's the first time that we've ever beat Man City, and we'll take it as we move on to an away fixture, as we move to South London to take on the Spurs. Come on, you Spurs! Gomez now starting the highlights off. Plays a lovely ball through to Memphis Depay. He's one-on-one, trying to pick out his space, and he's been tripped there. I don't see how that's not a penalty. Max Evans now on the wing. Step overs, gets away from his man, looking for a pass. He's got one now in Angel Gomez. Gomez gives it a read. Lewis Reed takes a touch, hits one towards goal, but it's a good save by the keeper. Last kick of the half now. Dele Alli getting away from a challenge, gives it a Kane. Look at the space Dele Alli's got. Hits one, but that's just wide of the post as the halftime whistle goes. Memphis now coming down the wing. Step overs, gets away from one, skips away from two, hits one towards goal. Good save by the keeper. Max Evans gets on the rebound, but he's offside, and the referee blows up. Not like that. Mason Price winning the ball back now. Lewis Reed gets it forward to Angel Gomez. Gomez waiting for a run. Look at the space Max Evans has got. Max Evans takes a touch, hits one. Good save by the keeper. Chance isn't over yet. Keeper comes out for that for some reason. Gomez turns his back. Price battling with Pjanic in the middle. Gets the better of him and hits it into the top right corner. Mason Price, what a man. Don't know why the keepers came out for that, but Gomez does well to keep his cool. Mason Price, they're just battling with Pjanic. No one's getting that ball off him. And it's a good finish for a centre-back. He's a centre-back. Tottenham now looking to instantly level it up. Kane gives it to Lucas. Lucas back to Kane. And that is outstanding. Out of this world. But what can you really do when Tottenham have powers of the afterlife? Because as you can see here, Kane and Lucas magically disappear. This game is broken. But anyway, enough about supernatural powers. Let's have a look at that finish. It's the curl. It's the power. It's mainly the height that gets the better of Oblak here. It's just out the reach of Oblak. It's perfectly heighted. Look, Oblak's got no chance. Tottenham coming forward again now. Up to Harry Kane. Harry Kane pings one towards the other side for Son. Son heads it down for Dele Alli. And again, Tottenham score their second screamer of the match. When the computer want to score, there's literally nothing you can do about it. I thought the chance was gone when Kane spread it that wide, but that finish is unreal. unreal. We might as well keep the fucking kickoff in, shall we? Gomez here, trying to get away from his man, instantly loses the ball, and here we go. Dele Alli and Kane playing a few 1-2s. Kane now stepping away from his man into Son, and the South Korean gives it back to Harry Kane, back to Son, and he's going to do it all himself. Steps inside one, step overs around the other, and again, they plop it into that top right corner. I don't know why I said plop it. I don't know why I said plop it, but it's a gorgeous finish. Son absolutely bamboozled me with those step overs there. And again, into that top right corner. There must be a magnet there for the ball to keep going there. I have no idea. And that's how that one finished. Our second loss of the season. And when Tottenham decided to play, we really had no chance. They waited for us to go 1-0 up before they decided to start playing some football. And once they did, three absolute worldies. But another disappointing result. And that is the end of these highlights. And we're back. So you saw Leicester, which ended in a 1-0 defeat. You saw Man City, which ended in a 1-0 win. And Tottenham, which ended on a 3-1 loss. Tottenham scoring three absolute bangers. But in between those, there was Norwich. Before Norwich, there was Luton in the quarterfinal of the Carabao Cup, which we won. So we're through to the semis and we faced West Ham. Look at the state of that. There was also after, because Man City and Tottenham happened one after another. And that was that. And then we faced Burnley, which was a 0-0 draw. And then there was Southampton, which we won 1-0. And that leaves us still in second place. It's not going to be there because it's the FA Cup. Hang on a second. That leaves us still in second. Our first two losses of the season. And Man United also lost another game. But when they lost the game, we also lost the game. So we didn't take advantage of that. And we still find ourselves 6 points behind them. At just after the halfway point of the season now. I think the league is pretty much, I don't want to say done, because we know that teams can bottle bigger leads. Hi, I'm a Liverpool fan. Still not over that. Where are Liverpool? Oh my god, Liverpool are 15th. Let's not talk about it. Let's go up here. Let's just, ooh, look at this top four. Fucking hell. So if they still just keep on winning, then there's really nothing we can do. So I'm just a bit disheartened right now. We need Man United to go on a massive losing run. And we do actually have them in this episode. We'll play them again today just to see if, again, we can beat them and reduce that gap to three. But I think what we're going to do is, I don't really know what I'm going to do next episode, because if it's next episode, I mean, if we win this semi-finals, the next episode, I'll finish it on the Carabao Cup final. We'll play that game. But if we don't, and we don't have that, then I'll just skip through the entire season until like the last month or something and come back for that. But we'll see what next episode will be after the semi-finals. So we're going to play this QPR game. We're going to sim that one. We're going to sim that one. We're going to play that one. We're going to sim that one. And we'll finish with West Ham as well. So we've got West Ham three times this episode. Two of them at home. Good. We only have to go to West Ham ground once, because if we went there more than once, we'd be stabbed, mainly by Millwall fans. Actually, before we sort this team out, let's actually go meet someone. Now, I've signed somebody. In the last one, there was a poll saying, who do you want us to buy, Reece James or Max Aarons? Last time I checked, anyway, Reece James was winning, so I went to the transfer hub. I went to, let's actually do what I just did, shall we? So I went to the transfer hub, I looked for him, oh, Reece James, approached to buy. Sorry, he's not for sale. All right, then I'll loan him in for the season, maybe. Sorry, he's not for sale, so I can't do that. So I went for Max Aarons, and I got him. Max Aarons is now a Peterborough player. I didn't mind who it was. I didn't mind if it was Reece James or Max Aarons. I like Reece James because he's got a higher rating and I think probably higher potential, but I like Max Aarons mainly because of how good he is for me on Football Manager 19. And he can't make his debut because he's injured, but he's in now for the future, so. And he costs us, what, 3.5? Not even 3.5. 3 mil, just over a 4% sell-on clause, which is stupid. And he actually took a bit of a pay cut. He was on 32 grand a week. He's on 28 grand a week for us now. So I'll sort this team out, and then we'll get into the game. But you all need to see that. So let's do the wash. Into the game. At the Airbox yet again. Peterborough versus Queen's Park Rangers. We've gone with a bit of a weakened side. But our weakened side is still, I'd say, still better than their side from top to bottom. I don't actually know where QPR are right now, not like in real life. I don't know where they are. They're not in the league. They're not in the Prem. They're probably in the Championship still. So here's our lineup. Then we've gone with Christian, Dodo's keeping his place, Benucci, Ampadu, Loyola. Don't worry, Jack Ampadu won't make mistakes. I'm going to try and avoid that. Woodgin, Mason Price, Harvey Hall, Eddie at Cam, Ablovsky over there on the left, and Moussa Barrow up top. So let's have a look at the QPR lineup, because I want to see if there's anybody there that I'll recognise. Any referral for Lynch, Hammer, Scamalongo, absolutely no one there that I recognise. So There's their lineup. You've seen ours. Let's get at the game. Let's progress to the next round, please. We don't have to play Coventry this time. So that's a bit of a... It's an upside because... Oh, Coventry. I hate them so fucking much. Anyway, let's get at the game. Up the posh. Come on. Harvey Hall. Could be a good start here. Could be a great start here. And Kenny, it's going to fall. Oh, my God. Within 2 minutes, we're in front. Musa Barrow gets Peterborough off to a flying start. What a move by the B-side here. I mean, that is unreal. That is unreal. Within 2 minutes, we've really come from kickoff here. It's a what a fantastic ball through. Eddie there. Keeper's a big... I don't know why the keeper's done that. Keeper's came for that when there's really no need to. And Barrow there getting ahead of his man, just poking it in with his left. And what a start for the boys. 2 minutes into our FA Cup campaign, and we're already ahead. What a start. They've lost the ball here. Hang on. We'll see if we can get on that. It's always a bit of a mistake. We're all over them. QPR after that early goal. They're panicking. They are panicking. Man, and good first touch to get away from his man. Ball in, not the best. Price sweeps it up. I love Mason Price so much. Musa Barrow. Out wide to Harvey Hall. Double H now. Tisk. Good touch. Over the top to Ablovski. I don't know whether he's kept on side. He has done. Eddie's going to take that off him. Jesus Christ, Eddie. He's still got it. He's took it a bit wide. Great first touch to get away from his man. Don't know why I called it first touch. It wasn't the first touch. Barrow. Harvey Hall. We're two up within 12 minutes. Double H. I've put us two up. What a start from us. QPR just can't deal with this. They cannot deal with our quality. Great little drag back from Nketiah. Barrow there. Good touch. Good foot. I can't actually talk today. I can't actually talk. Good shot by Barrow. Keeper there. Maybe could have put it in a better position. But Double H there, just squeezing it in from a tight angle. 2-0 up within 12 minutes. Oh, this could be a cricket score. Barrow ball over the top. Look at that. Look at the way the defender just didn't run with Eddie there. It's shockingly bad. It's like watching fucking Mustafi. Dodo gets rid. See if we can break from this. Harvey Hall over the top maybe. He's being held up there as Musa. He's going to get the better of it. That is a penalty all day long. Their captain there just diving in for no reason. We'll see what the booking is here. Is he not being booked? Oh my days. He might give a free kick for that. I don't know whether he's going to give a free kick for this. Are you dumb? Are you dumb? It's a free kick right... It was not that far out the box, like. Was it hell that far out the box? Give me an instant replay of that. Where are we gonna say that the contact? Where are we gonna say that the free kick should be given? Are we gonna say where he starts to slide in or where contact? It's where contact's made, right? So he starts to slide in there, but there's no contact until there. That's when Musa starts to go down. So that is right on the edge of the box. Look at Musa's foot there. But he's given it when he starts to slide in. He's given it from there. That's where he's given it from, which is wrong. Which is wrong. It's not a penalty. I'll take that back because it's not a penalty. But it's definitely not this far outside the box. I'll take it anyway because look at him. Look at... Oh, they've marked him. They've marked him. Oh, hang on. Somebody's made a sneaky run there. And he's just ran away. Well, that was a waste. Musa. Eddie made a fantastic run. I think he's a bit offside there. What a finish. He was offside, but what a finish. This man takes it down inside to that man. They've just got names that are far too difficult to pronounce. Like, they've all got Polish names. They just do. All of them have got Z's and Y's in and stuff, and there's just no need. Good tackle, Ablovski. Musa, back to Ablovski now. Options in the middle. He's going to try and swing it towards the back post. Well, I tried to swing it towards the back post. I don't know what that fucking idiot was doing. Musa, Lewis Reed, who's just on the pitch. Out wide to Ablovski now. Ablovski, step inside. That's not where I aim that at all. Ablovski, do you want to do what I tell you to do, or are you just going to be a stubborn little bastard? Gomez. He's took one too many touches then. I think Lewis Reed's offside. He's not. I thought he was. Would you? Fuck it. Have a pop. Have a pop! Always took deflection. Saved. Out for a corner. And there's the full-time whistle. 2-0. After I said, oh, it could end up being a cricket score. No. The chances dried up like the Sahara fucking desert. After that, the passing was off. Ablovski just decided to not do what I was doing. Fucking the chances were dead. The defenders were the passing. Oh my god, that passing in that game was fucking awful. They should have had a yellow card, maybe even a red, but you know, we'll take it. And yeah, we advance to the next round. We won't know who we've got straight away because of the replays and stuff. But we'll get on to the next game, which will be simmed, and it will be against West Ham in the first round. Not the first round, the first leg of the semi-finals of the Carabao Cup. Right then, so we'll play the B team in this game. And we sim. Here we go then, boys. Let's see if we can take a good result into the second leg. Still nothing happening. Absolutely nothing. And oh, Dodo there, getting us in front. 22 minutes in, Ampadu getting a yellow card because you know he's not the best. Still nothing really. Loyola 2-0. Our fullback's getting the jobs done here. See if we can get a third and really put the game beyond any doubt. As long as they don't score, we'll take a 2-0 lead at the second leg. And we do. Great result for the first leg. So we'll simulate this Leicester game as well. Probably a mistake, but we'll go for it anyway. Come on. We need a win here, boys. I probably should have played it, but I'm a bit of a twat. 30 minutes, nothing really happening yet. Still nothing. Absolutely nothing. Still nothing. Still... Ah, shit. Come on, a late equaliser. Well, that's not good, is it? 1-0. I don't know why I'd sim that. Right, so we're going to play this next game then. It's against Manchester United. They're now 7 points ahead of us after we lost to Norwich. They drew the last game, so we could have reduced the gap, but we didn't because we lost to Leicester. So we'll see if we can reduce the gap again like we did last time. We beat them, was it 1-0 last time? 1 or 2? I think it was only 1. So we'll see if we can do that again. I think we're away at Old Trafford this time. We are, so let's get into it. Come on, boys. Oh, look at that. Okay, FIFA with the cinematics. I've never seen that before. So we're at Old Trafford, the theatre of shite right now. So we'll see who they have gone with then. They've gone with De Gea in goal, obviously. Sergio Roberto, Regani, Smalling and Dalot at the back. Then Barella, Pogba and Golovin as a midfield three. Vasquez, Lukaku and Martial up top. Jose is still in charge for some God knows reason. I have no idea why. So, they've kicked off. We're off. Come on, boys. Let's just... We need, again, Operation Stop Man United. Because we need to... We've won the ball already. Angel Gomez. See if we can get off to a flying start. Hang on. Memphis. Good overlap and run by Max Evans. Max Evans cuts inside. Hit one. It's a good save by De Gea. Great start. Sirachi. Near the corner flag. I want to find... Yep, that's exactly where I wanted that pass to go. That sounded sarcastic, but it wasn't. Have a pop, Max. Oh, he's in the bar. Oh, Max Evans. Off the crossbar slash post. It was right in that top corner there. Unlucky. Sirachi. Max Evans is making a run on the inside. Lewis Reed. Go up to Dodo. First touch. Whip it in. It's a great ball. Why didn't Gomez go for that? Why didn't Gomez just stick out a foot? He would have fucking scored. Vasquez, Barella, Lukaku, Pogba. This is great football from him. Barella right at all. Blackie should have caught that off the bar by Martial. Oh, we've got away with that one. I feel like Oblak should have caught that there. It wasn't too powerful. It wasn't, you know, that powerful that he couldn't catch it. And we've given the ball away here. We could be in trouble again. Vasquez, ball in. Oh, God, Jesus Christ. Half-time, 0-0 in the second half. We've been the better team here. And normally I'd be like, oh, yeah, take a point. Oh, I've lost the ball straight away from kickoff. Normally I'd be like, oh, yeah, we'll take a point. But now with this, this is the last time that we'll play them in the league this season. So this is the last time I can guarantee them a loss. This is the last time that I can have any say in results. Stop giving the ball away! Lewis Reed, Hendricks, Memphis maybe can get a run. Shoot, back across De Gea with another good save. Oh, from the corner, it's too close to De Gea. Punches it away though. Don't run away from the ball, Pagola, you twat. Have a pop. Oh, it's in the bar again! Are you dumb? Oh, for fuck's sake. Are you crazy? No, that's stupid. That's fucking stupid. One chance and they fuck. Oh, I've dominated them. And then look at the fucking, who's marking? Oh, that's ridiculous. That's stupid. That's actually fucking stupid. They don't deserve that at all. They don't deserve that at all. Jose Mourinho's parked the bus again and he gets fucking one chance. The fucking fraud. And we've lost. Brilliant. And we've lost. Ah, lovely. We don't deserve that at all. They had one chance and they just took it. We couldn't finish our dinner and we've lost again. And at the second leg of the Carabao Cup then, we've got a lead. I think it was, I can't actually remember how big the lead was. I think it was 2-0, wasn't it? So a draw will take us through and we really need to, you know, if we bottle this, then fucking hell. But 45 minutes gone, still 0-0 as it stands. We're going to the final. I'm going to skip and extend 0-0. We're going to the final. We're going to Wembley for our third Carabao Cup final. So we've got Huddersfield in the FA Cup now. And you know what? We're going to play it. And then we'll finish it after this one. And then when's the Carabao Cup final? So it's then, and we play Tottenham. So we'll finish next episode on that. We'll come back for Arsenal. We'll do highlights of these two. And then Chelsea and Tottenham have finished that episode off. So we'll play this game against Huddersfield in the FA Cup. Let's see if we can progress to the next round. Right then, so we're at the Kirkley. It's not, it's a John Smith Stadium. That's how I call it anyway. Take on Huddersfield. I don't think there'll be anyone in there that I know. So we won't bother with the lineups. Ours is our B team, pretty much apart from a few here and there. So let's get into the game. They're going to kick us off. Let's do it, boys. Up the posh. Come on. Nketiah slips it through to Memphis. Memphis Depay, and we're ahead. 5 minutes in. Memphis Depay gets a goal. That puts us in a great position. Great start from us again. We start the FA Cup games very quick. We just come at them because we've got nothing to lose here. Lovely ball through by Eddie. Just slips it through to Memphis. Gives it the eye. Sits the keeper down. Puts it in that bottom corner. We'll take that, boys. Great start. Oh, dear. Oh, good, good. Thank God he messed that up. The way it just dropped to him then, it was just like, oh, here we go. Memphis rides the tackle. Give it back. Pagolo, turn. Have a pop. Yes! Come on! Pagolo puts us 2-0 at the good. Probably putting this game beyond any doubt now. Huddersfield haven't really offered anything else in the game. Good work here by Memphis to just avoid the tackles. Pagolo there just turned loads of space from there, and he just powered it into the top left corner. 2-0 to the good. Looks like we are going to the next round. I don't know whether it's the fifth round or the quarterfinal. I don't know which one it is. I know it's definitely the fifth round, but is the fifth round the quarterfinal? I have no idea. Oblovsky cuts inside his man. Ball in. Harvey Hall. Oh, he's put it wide. Pagolo Gomez off the post. Memphis. Oh, what a block. And there's the full-time whistle through to the next round. Get him, boys. We were all over them. Huddersfield, they just couldn't deal with the quality. So we're through with the fifth round. I don't know whether that's a quarterfinal or not. I don't know. So yeah, good win then. And we'll take it all day long. On to the next round. That's what I'm going to finish it for. David, and jump short, leave a like and subscribe. And I'll be back probably next week for the next episode. We'll do West Ham and Wolves in the spare time. And what the fuck is going on there? Arsenal in the league. And then the Carabao Cup final, the day off. What the fuck is wrong with this? Eh? That can't be right. Maybe when the next round of the FA Cup gets drawn, that'll be moved. But I don't. If not, we've been shafted. We've been shafted. So anyway, no matter what, we're gonna finish next episode with that Carabao Cup final. So if it stays like that, we'll do highlights of West Ham, Wolves, Brighton, and Palace, and then come back for Chelsea, Arsenal, Tottenham, and we'll just leave it at that. But hopefully those games get rearranged. But yeah, like I said, that's what I'm going to finish for today. If you didn't drop a short, leave a like and subscribe. If you want to follow me on Twitter, anything at all, links are in the description. But yeah, that's it from me. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like, subscribe, all that stuff. But more importantly, have a nice day.